Chad Wallz. I'm a beatmaker from Melbourne. I'm originally from Tasmania. I'm a Bulls fan since like 93. I watch a lot of basketball. I make beats. I like to drink beer. And I was the feature artist for Electric Relaxation for November. My older brother, he was a drum and bass DJ in Melbourne. So he kind of taught me a lot about music. I used to sneak into his bedroom and listen to Beastie Boys and, Rakim and all this crazy hip hop that I didn't even understand. And I must have just started writing fucking words on paper. And yeah, I found a piece of paper at my mum's house. I was like, fuck yeah, and I kept it. I started out as a b-boy, so I started breaking and teaching kids and stuff, yeah, so. But I've been in Melbourne for about 12, 13 years. The music scene in Melbourne's huge and always has been. I was excited when I first got over here. When I moved in with my friend, he was already in a hip-hop group already, so we started playing a lot of gigs in Melbourne straight away, which is awesome. I was doing a lot of emceeing at that stage, and the only sort of beat making that I was doing was just for us to rap over. MCing got me into more of the music side of things, and I think producing is something I've fallen in love with and I feel comfortable with now, you know. I listen to a lot of music, but the problem about listening to a lot of music, I get inspired too quickly and I'll start making music. So to relax, I usually listen to like 60 soul music. Gets me every time, I love it. There's something about just the raw recordings and just that, the feeling that I get listening to soul music. I love jazz, I love a bit of funk, I'm in the mood. I love 80s jams. I'm starting to love synth a lot more, which is why I bought this synth I have. I've always loved 90s boom bap, and I think, you know, I started doing that and I'll probably end up doing that at the end. Dad had this old, really old wooden organ, and nobody played it in the whole family, and I didn't know how to play it, but I'd sit there and it had this like little button that you'd press and it'd make like a really, really bad beat, just a shitty beat. It'll just go boom, psh, boom, psh, and I'd get on the keys and I'd just go. It was fucking horrible. Project I'm working on now is a lot of 80s synth tracks that I've been listening to for over a year now, and just trying to figure out what I want to sample. I've layered the samples over top with my own synths. Once I started doing that, I'm like, I want to start creating from scratch. So instead of actually sampling these days, I've just been making my own synth lines and stuff, which is awesome. So, but half of it's going to be sample with synths, and the rest of it's just going to be all my original, synth stuff, with my drums over top. The way I got into Labco was actually through playing at Beat Lab, playing like small little sets and stuff there. I was asked to join the collective, which is awesome. I love it, and we've done a lot as a collective now. We've seen each other grow as a crew, and individually we've grown. We've done tours around the world, which is sweet. Not only that, but we're all basically a family. We're all like on the same page with everything. We're all friends at the end of the day, which is sick. But yeah, I think I want to do another tour somewhere. I'm not too sure yet. I've been thinking about trying to hook up some shows in Europe. So now that I've done Japan, I've done United States, so I want to go over further and do some Europe stuff. I've been to like Electric Relaxation plenty of times, so I kind of knew what to expect, but it was awesome to be a part of it. And it was full professional too. You guys killed it. I think what ER's doing at the moment is already connecting people in ways where a lot of people would never, where would I have found Loopy if it wasn't for ER?